typically, when you think biscuits and gravy, you think a little white gravy, a little pork sausage. But this is the barbecue show. We're all about smoked meats. So we're here in Lakeview at a spot that does brisket for breakfast. Southport Grocery and Cafe takes pride in putting their own spin on traditional comfort dishes. Like with their customer favorite, the brisket, biscuits, and gravy.
Now this is our barbecue show, and Okay. Everybody loves a good brisket. So you guys actually do brisket for breakfast.
Right, right. First we smoke it to get some really good flavors, and then we braise it to make it tender and really juicy. And then it sounds like we're very unhealthy. Let's put in this lovely cream sauce and put on our house-made biscuits.
Brisket for breakfast. I like it.
Sounds good.
Meet up with Derek where he already has the applewood wood chips going so we can start repping the meat.
So I really do simple seasoning, just kosher salt and black pepper. Pretty thick cut of meat so it can handle a substantial amount of salt.
One more?
I think, yeah, you go one more and that's probably good.
All right, generous with the pepper too.
Yeah, pretty generous with the pepper.
I'm gonna try not to sneeze.
The pepper also helps it. We've dried the meat as best we can because before you smoke it, you want to have the meat dry.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the smoke will not adhere to the meat. So you want to create somewhat of a pellicle, which is very dry meat, and the
pellicle.
Smoke will adhere
we
to
may
it.
Have to put the definition of that one up on the screen. I don't know what pellicle is.
We are ready to place this in the smoker, so Yeah. Let's lay that right in the middle there.
Once it's smoked, we're not even close to being finished.
Now we have to braise.
Now we have to braise it.
Which means adding in some water and mixed veggies, otherwise known as the...
Mirepoix.
Okay. We keep things moving along by adding in some wine, brown sugar, and fresh herbs before this hunk of meat is ready to bake. But I don't have all day. So Derek has some ready to be mixed in to make the gravy.
So our gravy is almost done. The brisket's just kind of worked its way.
It's got all creamy, so what we're kind of doing is we're trying to cook the flour out.
Mm-hmm.
And so just whenever time you use flour as a roux to thicken anything like a gravy, you want to cook it down.
Cook it down. So we got that, now it's the eggs.
Now we're going to cook the eggs.
While the eggs simmer on the stove, it's time to drench the homemade biscuits in the brisket gravy sauce.
We got a friend downstairs. I'm gonna bring him his breakfast. Nice work, Derek.
I've been going here for about 4 years now and discovered this meal. One of my friends worked here, told me that brisket and gravy is what I had to have, so I've just been loving it ever since. It's fantastic. And it's mainly because of the smoky flavor and the way it mixes with some of the sweet in there.
Mm-hmm.
The red pepper flakes on the top, a little smoky, a little sweet, a little spicy.
What is it about the biscuits and gravy here? What makes it so good?
You know, I think it's just the fact that they put beef brisket in it, a smoked brisket, as opposed to your typical pork. A lot of biscuits and gravy have pork sausage, and the way they smoke their brisket and then add the egg on top, it's just delicious.
Most people wouldn't think any barbecue for breakfast, but this actually really works. Send us your suggestions, any other barbecue places you think we should know about, Facebook, or you can send me a tweet at Brittney Payton at Chicago's Best TV. Cheers.